Hello, future self. Right now I have just booked here to a a resort. Unfortunately, the trip to Martin's Bay did not work out. Oh my god, I don't know what's going on with my hair. It's old, so it's like Tumakens Bay did not work out because the transport was expensive, and I was like, oh my god, no, this is just too much. Let me rather find a place near East London that will cost as much as Tumakens Bay Hotel and just go there, because that way I'm going to minimize the transport costs. And I found it, you won't believe it. It's a premier, like premier resort. Like, I'm so excited. It's so beautiful. But you know what? No buts. It's beautiful. It is beautiful. And what I've learned this year, starting from your graduation, is that you fall in love with something. But because in the last video I was talking about how it was love at first sight, you look at something and you fall in love with it, but it doesn't mean that it's what it was meant for you or it's meant to be. Just because you look at something and you like it, it's not a sign from heaven that you should go for it. I think that's a lesson you learned from this experience, that when you see something and you like it, it doesn't mean that you should go after it. It doesn't mean that it's yours. Anything, be it a person, a shoe, or just anything. So today it's Thursday, the 22nd of August, and I just finished packing. Oh my god, I cannot believe it. Like, I'm so exhausted right now because I am hungry and I'm tired. I'm done packing. I am leaving tomorrow, and oh, I'm so excited and nervous at the same time, because like, you never know what to expect, especially going alone. So it's like nerve-wracking but exciting. So yeah, let me just show you what I packed. There is my suitcase. So at first, like, I was kind of hesitant to take this suitcase because it just looked huge for somebody just going for a weekend. So this side I have my toiletry bag with my toiletries inside, a bag that I will be using on Saturday and maybe tomorrow because I wanted to bring along snacks and everything. So I also want to use it to carry my tripod and my tripod and stuff on Saturday. And then I have this bag over here. This one has like my earrings and lipsticks in it and my lunch money. Yeah, I don't know if I'll be using this bag, but like, I just brought it just in case. And I have my book, my 21st birthday present from Tanya, which is like best book. So I just want to remind myself the code. I have my sun hat here, and that is the first side. I will just close it when I'm done. And then over this side I have my clothes. It does look like a lot of stuff for a weekend, but anyways, I'm going to need every outfit. I'm not going to go in detail with my clothes because like, it's a lot and I've already packed. But anyways, this is my swimwear.
and I'll wear this skirt just to cover up my swimwear. And this is my skirt. I'll wear this top on Sunday, this skirt on Saturday, this top on Saturday, and this dress on Sunday when I'm coming back. I also brought some stuff like these over here, which I will wear at night because they are kind of warm clothes. And then I brought shorts, my denim shorts, just in case I want to swim again. I have my pajamas over here and my sweater, so that when it gets cold. I also have like my jacket underneath there, my green jacket, in case it gets cold while I'm over there. But anyways, other than that, that's all I have. Tomorrow I will pack my flip-flops, my charger, and my flip-flops, my charger, my towels, and I think that's all. Oh, and my sunglasses. Oh my god, thank god for this video, because I forgot these over here. I forgot to put them in, so let's just close this. I don't think they will both fit in this thing, so let me just do this. These are my glasses, my new sunglasses that I bought on Mr. Price. Oh, I think they are too big to get in here. And these are my old Mr. Price sunglasses. I'm also bringing them along just in case. So there, that's all that I've got packed so far. I'll be using this to vlog and stuff, and my tripod to take pictures and some vlogs. But other than that, I am ready to go. I've been a little indecisive of what to wear tomorrow, but I've already ironed these are my white pants and my orange top, and I want to put my head wrap on this one tomorrow, so I had to wear the orange top to match. I also, like, I had other options like wearing a dress or wearing my jeans. I just couldn't decide, but I've ironed those out. I'll see tomorrow. Another thing, I wasn't sure to wear that outfit with my tankies or with a sandal, but I'll see tomorrow when I'm dressing which looks better. Yeah, all right, the trip is happening and I'm so excited, and I'm really hoping they have iron over there, because like I did iron my clothes, but I feel like they are going to need more ironing by the day I wear them. But anyways, other than that, I'm ready to go. It's a weekend getaway, baby, and I really needed this, guys. I really needed this. Like, I'm exhausted, as you can see me. It's really hard. Like, academics can drain you, y'all. So yeah, see you tomorrow. There is my ride. Yep, that's my ride. So it's time for me to go.
Should know this ain't the type of shit I go. She asked me, Junior, do you like it when I cry, huh? Do you consider my feelings when you lie, huh? You put me second to some bitch on the side, what? You just gon' let her ride or die, die inside? Damn, you forget I was with you before the racks came, before these skanks came, before the plaques came, before you started getting money and your raps changed. I was with you when you were still thinking about changing your rap name, nigga. Say something now. Are you choking? Baby, I'm sorry. Are you joking? So much for convincing me to be open. I don't know why I bother with you when you've clearly chosen. This music over me, it owns all your emotions. And you really have to give it your undivided devotion. But somehow my heart feels safer when you hold it, like you're not the one that broke it.
End up falling for you. I find myself calling for you. Into the dark I followed you, but I should know this ain't the type of shit I go through. Send me away, send me away.
Joburg working, and you know I need money. Instead of telling me you hurt and focus more on your studies, I'm not ignoring you, trust me. I'm always busy with something. You called too late or too early, I couldn't talk, I was grumpy. Couldn't talk, you were grumpy. We're supposed to... Junior, you told a hoe you don't love me. She posted about it, you dummy. All I ever did was love you. I don't deserve to be punished. I cut off all my friends for you. What more do you want from me? You cheated too. That was so long ago. What am I doing? We dated long ago. That makes it cool. I said I'm sorry though. Fuck we are doing all alone, huh? Guess I've always been a dummy. Bitch, I dare you to lie to me and say you told him you love me. And you know what? I should've known you were hiding something. You laughed at everything he said. That nigga wasn't even funny. You made me feel so insecure and weak as fuck. But I'm not sending you away, so you gon' have to run for me, cause I still love you.
End up falling for you. I find myself calling for you. Into the dark I followed you, but I should've known this ain't the type of shit I go through. Send me away, send me away.
Hello, I just got at the Premier Pongo Reserve, okay? The drive was like 45 minutes or 35 minutes, I'm not quite sure, but it was just a short drive from East London. Okay, so yeah, I just checked in now, so I'll give you a tour of my room. So this is my room. That's my bed. It's a quite a small room. I've got a mirror there. Yeah. I got a mirror here. Lamp, and then that's like the window, the patio. In inverted commas, the pantry in inverted commas, okay. That's the side that we traveled in. I've got a dressing table, if it's a dressing table, and they've provided me with
plenty of facilities, which is great. Although I'm not a tea person. We've got a candle here. I'm thinking if maybe there's no electricity. Premier. I'm here, baby. We've got a magazine here. And what's this? This is like the welcoming thing that has all the important information. For instance, here we have the times for breakfast and dinner, and what time the reception and the restaurants open, and some rules. Yeah, and this is my wardrobe for the weekend. So yeah, that's my room. Let's go to the bathroom. This is the door to the bathroom. I've got a shower. I was hoping for a bath tub, but it's okay. I've got a shower. There is my sink. And there's the toilet. Maybe that's a bathroom. Okay, I gotta say, this is awkward because imagine somebody sitting out there and you are busy here pooping. Come on. There's some mirror. Okay, let's see if I've got any free goodies. I've got a... what's this? But the shower gel. Green earth, a shower cap. Ooh. And an this is a shampoo. It's quite awesome. And then they said that I shouldn't drink any water from the sink. I should use this water. This question, please do not drink tap water. Fresh water has been provided, which is that. Okay. And that is my room. Towels
and more towels.
It's quite a huge shower though. I hope it's done. Okay, that is my room. This is my room. Okay. That's all there is. Right now, like, it's so quiet in here. Like, it's literally so quiet. I am not sure what to do at the moment. Because, like, I don't even have a book.
And we survive the thunder and escape the hunger. And sometimes I wonder how we got the. Who knows what the last is? We don't need no answers, cause we stand and serve as living proof.
Man of Don, catch me ballin' out in London. Tom Brady with the paper, I go Super Bowl Sunday. You son, Bolt, crazy running to the hundreds. I keep my neck
on my wrist at least 100.
Hood nigga with the money and they loving it. She got comfortable, she called me by my governor. Pull up in the Rolls with the white seats and pull off in a Porsche like a car thief. I'm cocky, beat that pussy up like Rocky. I fly to Amsterdam for the right fee. These dudes ain't nothing like me, they car thieves. I booked her for the night, paid a bar fee. Told her, charge it to the game, Black Wall Street. Shark blue coupe with the shark feet. Once a millionaire can't get them off me.
Put your man a gun, catch me ballin' on.
We survive the thunder and escape the hunger. And sometimes I wonder, we got the. Who knows what the last. fast car. I got a dream of something. You are a hot wire. I like to push your buttons. We gotta somehow get out of town. We drove for ages, never looking backwards. They wanna cage us, but we prefer our freedom. Call us outrageous. Well, how about now?
Diablo, Cuba. Gucci man, the gun, catch me ballin' out of line. Did some braided with the paper, I go Super Bowl, signed it. You signed bold, crazy, running to the hundreds. I keep my neck and my wrist at least 100. Hood nigga with the money and they loving it. She got comfortable, she call me by my government. Pull up in the Rolls with the white seats. And pull off in a Porsche like a car thief.
Just looking around for the pool and I cannot find not even one. I'm going to start asking from people. So I am going to continue the struggle of looking for a pool. I am so tired of looking everywhere, so I think I should just walk here. It's like in the thing it was written Hubeta Pool and I am residing at Hubeta. I cannot find Indlovu does to look for it there. I thought it was connected to the restaurant, but it's not.
Change for anybody else. Have you looked in the mirror lately? Wish you could.
Hello. So, I looked for the pool everywhere. And then I finally asked someone who is a staff member, and they told me that in this lodge there is no pool currently, so you have to use the other lodge's pools. And to get there, because it's a little bit far, you have to request transport from the reception. So that's what I'll do tomorrow, because that was my plan for tomorrow, since I'm not doing the game drive thing, that I am going to eat my breakfast and then go chill by the pool and read my book while listening to my music and just let nature sink in. So I just found out that. So in the morning, that's what I'll do. I'll go eat breakfast and then request, or before I eat breakfast, I'm going to request transport to get there. And then immediately after my breakfast, I want to leave around 8 a.m. to the place where there is a pool, so I can swim and chill by the pool. I have changed to warmer clothes because I was feeling a little bit chilly. It's a little cold outside, so I changed. I am speaking so low right now because I realized that people can hear. Like, I can hear people talking on the passages. So I'm like thinking, oh my god, they obviously hear me talking in my room. So that, if you can hear that, guys, people laughing. Yeah, that's what makes me shy, to speak louder and say okay, you know, and speak louder. Yeah, so far it's been I don't know, because I just got here about 2 hours ago. I obviously walked around the place and it's beautiful, but I didn't get to really see its beauty, because while I was walking around, I was sort of looking for areas I can take pictures at, so I didn't really like get to see it. So I guess I'll do that tomorrow. Okay, right now, this is the outfit. This is quite warm, guys, and it is the only jacket that I brought. Like, right now I'm regretting, because I wanted to bring my denim jacket, but then I felt like my suitcase was already full. Where am I taking the denim jacket at? So I am wearing this right now, and it's hot. Okay, I am really warm, so I'm going to obviously carry it by hand at some point, because like, I'm very warm right now. Let me show you my alternated outfit, because it's the same outfit, but it just sort of changed here and there. That's my outfit. This is me right now. It's not really cute because of this jacket, but I think at some point I'm going to wear it like so. Oh my god, this jacket is holding on for dear life. There you go. I am going to go eat dinner in this outfit right here. I was thinking of changing and wearing like other pants, but I'm thinking, no, tomorrow I'm probably gonna need those pants, because I only brought two pants, the one I'm wearing and the black ones. High waisted black ones. So they said that dinner is between 7 p.m. and 9. And I'm thinking I'm going to go at what? I think at probably at 7, because like I don't want to be hungry by 9 o'clock or like 10 o'clock or 12 o'clock obviously. At the same time, I don't want to like eat late when it's like really dark outside, because as you guys saw earlier, the road to the restaurant is terrifying, like there are bushes all over, so I don't want to walk at night and maybe something jumps out of the way. So what I'm gonna do now, I brought myself like snacks and stuff. I'm going to eat my snack and while watching a series or something, and then maybe at 7:30 to 8 I go eat dinner. So right now I'm going to chill and just do exactly what I came here to do. Sausage and like, yeah, love myself.